Well, hello, everybody. My name's Elijah Wong. And if you don't mind, in 4/4 time, I'd like to sing a song. It's a little tune I wrote about the history of the Jews, dating back to Bible days when it was breaking news. It's about this dude named Moses, who's the star of this here show, and how he begged the Pharaoh to let my people go. But the Pharaoh was a bully, like that Mumser Donald Trump. A liar and a bragger, and a narcissistic chump. Let your people go, said Far. No deal, no way, no dice. So Moses warned that God will flood his house with crickets, frogs, and lice. Now let me make this clear, said Far, so you don't think I'm vague. You tell that low-life God of yours, he can send plague after plague. So Moses told the Lord of hosts that the Pharaoh was impious. And God slaughtered all his sheep and gave him the heartbreak of Sarai.
Oh, no, is that why I got it?
Now the Pharaoh went ballistic and told Moses God to kiss his ass. So God unleashed 2 million locusts and ate all the Pharaoh's grass. Then God sickened all their livestock and burned their wheat and corn and passed over their unmarked houses to slay their beloved firstborn. Okay, I give, said the Pharaoh, which meant he'd had enough. Then he freed 10,000 Jews who packed up all their stuff. But just like Trump, that two-time and slump, the Pharaoh broke his promise. He dispatched his men to enslave them Jews again like a no-good doubting Thomas. So the Jews made haste, with no time to waste or dawdle in the sun. No time to bake our matzo cake known as flatbread on the run. Then, miracle of miracles, the Jews found liberty when God drowned the Pharaoh's soldiers and split that old Red Sea. Now the Pharaoh's really fuming, seeing all his soldiers dead, which is why on this night of nights we eat unleavened bread. So here we are now shooting par. So here we are now shooting par. Some 5,000 years later, celebrating Passover at this beautiful sit-down Seder. And on this night we ask God to fight and free us from affliction. Enslaved by booze and pot and opioids and all manner of addiction. And in our quest to free ourselves from this wasteful toxic bind, it's magic how we each become like Moses in our mind. And that is why on this special night we thank the Lord our God who chose us to celebrate this holiday known as the Days of Wine and Moses. Yeehaw!